Good morning, YouTube people. Welcome to Zoe's Garden. On today's episode, I'm going to show you guys how I transferred and transplanted my dragon fruit and cuttings to a larger pot. So I have some purple one that I got from a nursery. And then this is a yellow one I got from a nursery. And then this is the red one I got from the Houston Bamboo Nursery. Surprisingly, they sold dragon fruit in addition to bamboo. So the red one I already started. And then back here, this is a cutting I traded with a neighbor. I posted that I wanted to trade. So that one's been rooted. And then I have some other cuttings that are not rooted, and those that I traded with a neighbor, unfortunately they didn't know what kind of dragon fruit they were, but I guess one day I'll know once they fruit, hopefully. So I started off with a potting mix, just your Miracle-Gro store-bought potting mix. I did amend it and add some perlite to it to aerate it some more. And then the last quarter of the top of the pot, I did add some black cow manure and then added some more perlite. Now, my handy dandy husband, as you know, built my container planter that I showed a few weeks ago. And he also built this dragon fruit trellis. So I used some 2x2 cedar for the top, and then for the center posts, it was just some 2x4 cedar. And at the bottom, there was some additional 2x2 on the flange part that you can't see, that's already been buried in the pot. But I'll show you on another one once I get started on some other pots. So once I do these, and then I'll show you what they look like after they're done. And this is what the bottom looks like with the 2x2 cedar flange. All right, so I've got everything transplanted into its permanent home with the trellis that my husband made. And this is the purple haze dragon fruit that I got from a nursery. And this is the red. And this is the yellow. And then this is the mystery one that I traded with a neighbor. So unfortunately we don't know what that is. And then this one is also another mystery one. And this one is cuttings. And it hasn't been rooted, so I'm gonna put it in the shade for a couple weeks. And once it's rooted, then I'll put it in full sun. But after I transplanted them and top dressed it with the black cow compost manure with some perlite, I also watered in with some fish and kelp fertilizer. And there you go. That's all my transplanted dragon fruit in its permanent home with the trellis made of cedar, 2x4 as the post, and the 2x2 for the umbrella top, which we haven't installed it yet. I'm waiting until the dragon fruit gets a little taller and it's a lot easier to maneuver. Then we'll install the tops to them with just a couple of screws. All right. Well, thanks for watching. If you like it, please subscribe, share it. Bye, y'all.